screaming, Cher, Cher, right? Well, we've seen Oscar-winning superstar Cher play many different characters. But in the new comedy, Stuck on You, she plays the biggest character of all, herself. Take a look.
I'm hot! Do you hear me? I am hot. Look what it says here, Howard. Okay, who's hot, who's not? Cher, red hot.
Of course you're hot. You're hotter than hot. You're on fire. There's no question about it.
Well, then answer me this. Why am I doing this lame-ass TV show when I should be doing movies?
Obviously, Cher was talking about another TV show. I was about to tell you how much I love her. I've interviewed her before. I always look forward to interviewing her again. I'm not so sure now. Please welcome Cher! Yeah! Screaming about Cher that I want you to know these are not her, these two cute guys are not her bodyguards. This is a boyfriend, sorry, maybe they are. Bobby and Peter Farrelly, who directed this. Yeah. This is Bobby. Yeah, you can tell they're not identical twins because they're dressed differently, right?
Right. Okay. And this is the good one. Need I say more?
So I was just, oh, pretty rings.
Thank you.
I was just, that's neither here nor there. I was just reading that you play a diva in this, and you had to hire an acting coach to teach you how to be a diva?
Well, no, this is what happened.
We had asked her to take it down a little.
These guys are so bad. I could tell you things, but
tell
I won't.
No,
because it'd have to be all bleeped. When I first got the script, no matter what they say, it just said actress. It didn't say Cher. It said somebody else's name. So they said, oh, you know, this would be great. And I thought, okay, I've never played a bitch, but I'm thinking Joan Collins, Madonna. This could be really fun. You know, Raquel Welch. And that's what got me in my mind. Okay, so, and then, after I was really excited, they said, you know, it would be great if you played yourself. And then I thought, oh, I don't think this is great anymore. And then I was really scared because I thought, how can I be myself, be this horrible bitch self, and not be actually talking, you know, like saying other dialogue. So I was really nervous. So yeah, I called this lady who's a great...
Who taught you how to be a diva.
She was very smart, though, because there was a moment where she thought, geez, you know, I'm playing myself. But when she committed, she showed up and said, look it, I understand what you're doing here. If we're going to do it, let's go all the way. Uh-huh. So she would push us, like make her worse, 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 because, you know, if it was kind of bad,
right,
people might think that is her.
Yeah.
But it was so over the top that, you know...
Would also come up with me like, you know, we don't know if this is over the top. This might be a little bit, you know, this might be a little bit too much, but how about this?
Yeah.
I go, okay, let's do that. I mean, after
let's go further.
Right.
Than that.
Yeah, let's go further.
The thing is, in all the years, you're not a bitch. And you're not a diva.
No.
You're not a demanding...
No, you know what? I'm really, as women go, I am so, you know, I can have the brown M&Ms. It doesn't bother me.
Don't have to sort through the M&Ms. You're right, Barbara. And I mean, you essentially, this is a parody of yourself. So, I mean, I think it's admirable that you can have such a sense of humor. I mean, you're seen in bed with a younger man, a boy, essentially.
That is not a stretch for Cher.
Come on. Mentally, how do you get through that scene?
The good thing was that I knew his name, but I'd never seen him.
It's Frankie Muniz, and thing is, though, the day he shot, he had actually turned 14 that day. So
he was okay. He reached the age appropriate.
Yeah, I was on the bed, and you know, it was lit so that everything around was dark. And out of the darkness comes this boy, skinny, tiny little boy.
Well, he's handsome.
No, he was adorable, and he jumps on the bed and takes off his shirt and says, It's okay, I've done my push-ups, so I'm pumped.
What a birthday present. But listen, you guys, I mean, honestly, your films appeal mostly to men a lot of the time. I mean, the humor is there. I walked into this film, absolutely loved it, knew I was going to laugh, but it's sentimental.
Yeah,
it grabbed
my friends
heart.
Cried.
Yes, I
That's
had
not
tears.
Very Farrelly.
It's
well,
not
it's
very
not.
Farrelly.
My mother cried when she saw Dumb and Dumber.
It was tears of joy.
Yeah.
But it really
well,
shows an intimate relationship of brothers.
We failed. You know, sometimes you don't hit a home run. No, we actually, this is our favorite movie because it's richer than our other movies. You know, it's a comedy, but it also
really
has
is.
Some twists and turns that are completely unexpected. And I'm most proud of this movie.
It's about conjoined twins, which doesn't
right.
sound too appealing, but the people who play
well,
it, the two guys who play it are certainly appealing.
Damon and Greg Kinnear.
Yeah.
And they're very successful conjoined twins. They were the kings of the prom. They were on the state championship hockey
right.
team.
It's
they're
so
the
funny.
Goalie. And they what happens is Greg decides he wants to try Hollywood, give it a crack, and now you think, okay, now they're going to get their butts kicked, but they're winners. They always
they
win.
Do.
And along the way, they bump into Shear, who
right.
at first is their nemesis and ultimately turns out to
Comes
be a friend.
Comes around and redeems herself.
Yeah. Thank you. You two guys, here you are, two brothers who work together and who I think are slightly crazy if you look at their movie. You didn't hear me say that.
Right.
Is there anything, Dumb and Dumber and Something About Mary, is there anything that you won't push the envelope for? Have you said, that's just too far for us?
If it's not funny, we go where we think is funny, and, you know, then ultimately the audience kind of decides. We listen to test audiences, and if we've gone too far, they sort of tell us. But we're willing to joke about a lot of things.
Do you both do both? I mean, do you write one page, you write one page, what do you...
Together, you know, do
these
the whole
are
thing.
The boys in the... This is Matt and Greg. I mean, these guys are the conjoined twins in reality.
Emotionally.
Right, yes.
Uh-huh.
They're
and
just,
you bring it in.
They can just change sides.
You
yeah,
know, it's a funny thing. In the United States, because we go around the movie, you know, take it around the world, and in the United States, you know, people are very nervous about, it's sort of our Puritan, you know, background. They're nervous about anything sexual or anything, or anything to do with people with disabilities. It's like, you know, cover that up. But on the other hand, like, you know, the Coen brothers, who I love, the greatest, but they can put a guy upside down in a wood chipper, and that's somehow arty.
Right.
You know, people are fine with that. It's a weird thing.
You're just
Cher. Yeah, Cher had like to be made fun of, too. Like everybody else.
You had to have some apprehension, Cher. I mean, we've seen hair gel. We've seen body parts and zippers. I mean, when you walked on, were there things you were afraid to do?
Absolutely. I just thought, this is going to be so much fun. And for me, it was hard because I was on the road. So when I would take time off on our breaks, I would, you know, hot-foot it down to Florida. So for me, it was a labor of love because I was already tired.
Well, what a fantastic tour you had, though. Everybody agrees.
Look at that.
Look, I don't care what color it is. You and I have talked to each other over the years. You look so beautiful.
She
you never change.
Show.
You are the best.
Yes,
we love you, and you two guys are too good. You opens this Friday. If you want to have a good time, this Friday, December 12th. I'll see you. We'll be right back.